Yes, good morning, children. Yesterday we saw about how the highest fluoride of manganese, that is MnF4, and the highest oxide is Mn2O7, and why it is so, because oxygen is having the ability to form multiple bonds with the metal atom. But fluorine, because it is univalent, it can make only one single bond. Now, basically I wanted to tell you that what is this electrode potential? Electrode potential is the sum of all these three reactions. Say metal in the solid state is first getting converted into metal in the gas state, and that is called as sublimation. And then M in the gas state is getting converted to M plus in the gas state, that is ionization. And then M plus in the gas state to M plus in the aqueous state is called as hydration. So the sum or the effect of all these three processes is nothing but electrode potential. Okay. Now in general, this is for any metal. Now supposing you take copper solid to copper gas, then it loses one electron to become Cu plus, that is first ionization energy. Then it loses another electron to become Cu2 plus, that is second ionization energy. And then this Cu2 plus, it is surrounded by water, and this is what you call it as delta H hydration. And Cu to Cu2 plus conversion, that is electrode potential, is the sum of all these three. Okay. And why Cu2 plus is more stable than Cu plus? That is because the amount of energy released during the conversion of, or during the formation of Cu2 plus aqueous form, is much more. So the Cu2 plus is associated with low energy state, and that is why it is more stable, or you will say that Cu2 plus is having, or is associated with, more negative hydration enthalpy. That is why it is more stable, and that is why Cu plus disproportionates to give you Cu2 plus and Cu. This is the reason, because Cu2 plus is associated with more negative hydration enthalpy, and the energy released during hydration can easily compensate the second ionization energy of copper. That is why it goes into Cu2 plus state. Now let us discuss more questions from this D block elements. So here, delta H atomization of 4D and 5D series is higher than those of 3D. Why so? This is because of more frequent metal-metal bonding between them. That is why 4D and 5D series, they are associated with more enthalpy of atomization. What is atomization? I told you, metal in the solid state getting converted into metal in the gas state. This conversion is stated as atomization. In the solid form, it is bound, and when it gets converted into gas, they become individual atoms in the free state. This is what is called as atomization. This can also be called as sublimation. Then, zinc, cadmium, mercury are soft metals having low melting points. Why? This is because in all the three, there are no unpaired electrons. Okay, if unpaired electrons are not there, then the metallic bonding will be weak. Is that clear? We saw that greater the number of unpaired electrons, greater the extent of metallic bonding. Okay, so these elements are supposed to be soft. Then, what are the factors on which electrode potential depend on? It depends on that just now we saw sublimation or atomization, then ionization, and then hydration enthalpy. All these three factors will decide the electrode potential of a particular species or a metal. Then E naught of Cu2 plus by Cu is plus 0.34. What does it indicate? This plus sign denotes that the conversion of Cu2 plus to Cu is spontaneous. Okay. Or you can say Cu in the metallic form is more stable than Cu2+. That is why Cu2+, if at all it gets a chance to get reduced, you and me cannot stop it from getting reduced to metallic copper. So this is the meaning of positive E0 value. That particular reaction is spontaneous. Now, I have given you the different oxides of manganese. MnO, Mn3O4, Mn2O3, MnO2, Mn2O7. Now you see the oxidation state of Mn in all the cases, 2+, then here it is 8/3, here it is +3, here it is +4, and here it is +7. Okay, now when you go from left to right, ionic character is decreasing and acidic character is increasing. What we have seen, greater the oxidation state, greater the covalent character. So that's why you say ionic character decreases. Greater the oxidation state, greater the polarizing power, greater the covalent character. This we have seen right since 11th class. Okay, greater the charge, greater the polarizing power, and greater the covalent character. Okay, so obviously ionic character decreases, and greater the covalent character, when you say greater the acidic character also. Now depending upon the necessity, we will use the terms. So ionic character decreases and acidic character increases. Then another question is, why is KMnO4 violet or pink in color when Mn7+ has no unpaired electron? In KMnO4, Mn is having +7 state and there is no unpaired electron. Okay, all the 7 electrons it is having, Mn is having 3d5 4s2. Now when all the 7 electrons are lost, that is how it will get +7 state, is it not? When there is no unpaired electron, how is it that it is showing color? The color is not due to DD transition. Otherwise, we saw in the case of complexes, the coloration is due to DD transition. But here it is due to charge transfer. Charge transfer ka matlab, the charge on oxygen, that is the electrons on oxygen, that will get transferred to the empty orbitals of manganese. So this charge transfer is responsible for coloration of KMnO4. Then this Mn3+ to Mn2+ E0 of this is more positive than that of Fe3+ to Fe2+. This is again a book question, dear children. These are very, very important ones. Now Mn2+ is having 3d5 configuration, which is stable. Okay, and Fe3+ is having 3d5, but Fe2+ is having 3d6. So Mn3+ to Mn2+ is more spontaneous because it is going towards half-filled electronic configuration, whereas Fe3+ has already stable 3d5 configuration, so hence it does not get reduced easily to Fe2+, right? So this is the reason why E0 of this is more positive than that of this. Then the next question, Cr is a hard metal, that is chromium is a hard metal, but mercury is a liquid. Why? Chromium has 3d5 4s1 configuration, and here you will find there are 5 unpaired electrons in the d orbital. Greater the number of unpaired electrons, greater the extent of metallic bonding. This we already saw. So it is hard. But in the case of mercury, zinc, cadmium, mercury, we already saw, they have fully filled configuration. Hg, zinc has 3d10 4s2. This should be 5d10 and the corresponding S level. So weak metallic bonding, and that is why mercury is a liquid, since it is having fully filled configuration. Please correct it, it is not 3d, right? That is the reason. Now A substance has a magnetic moment of 3.9 Bohr magneton. So how will you guess the number of unpaired electrons in it? So if it is 3.9, then the number of unpaired electrons are 3. If it is 4.9, then it is 4. Like that it will be assumed. Now, which has higher melting point? Is it iron or copper? Iron has iron melting point, higher melting point. Why? Because it has 4 unpaired electrons. Okay. Now, greater the unpaired electrons, greater the, stronger the metallic bonding. Okay. And copper has only 1 electron, that is in the unpaired state. Copper mein configuration kya hai? 3D10, 4S1. 3D10, 4S1. Whereas here it is 3D6, 4S2. So 6, when you consider 6, how do you draw the electrons? You will draw like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 4 unpaired electrons are there. Whereas in the case of copper, there is only 1 unpaired electron, that is in the 4S. So iron has stronger metallic bonds. Okay. Now, the lowest oxide of a transition metal is basic, while the highest oxide is acidic. This we saw in terms of manganese also, remember? Now, CrO is basic, but CrO3 is acidic. Now, CrO3 mein CrP oxidation state hogi plus 6, and in CrO, it will be plus 2, right? Higher the oxidation state, higher the polarizing power, higher the acidic character. Just now we saw it. So, higher the oxidation state, higher the tendency to gain electron pair and hence acidic. What is electron pair gaining? They are nothing but Lewis acids. Lewis acids are electron pair acceptors, as you know it already. Then, E0 of Cu2 plus bar Cu is plus 0.34. What is the reason for this? What does it indicate? We saw a question. Now, what is the reason for this? Now, here, this conversion we already discussed. Okay. Copper has high enthalpy of atomization. This is high. This conversion, solid to gas conversion, this is high, energy is absorbed, and low hydration energy. Delta H ionization energy is nothing but energy absorbed. Hydration energy is energy released, and atomization is again endothermic, it is energy absorbed. So high energy is required for ionization of copper to copper 2 plus, and the amount of energy released during hydration is insufficient to compensate the requirement of atomization and ionization. Is that clear? The amount of energy released is insufficient to compensate the requirement of this process and this process. That is why Cu to Cu2 plus is not spontaneous. Cu2 plus to Cu is spontaneous, but Cu to Cu2 plus is not spontaneous, or you can say Cu2 plus to Cu is spontaneous, or E0 is positive. Right? Then you have, what is the difference between transition and non-transition elements? When you consider transition elements, down the group, higher oxidation states are more stable. Then variability of oxidation state differ by unity among any element. You know that they show multiple oxidation states and they differ by one unit, 2 plus, 3 plus, 4 plus, like that. Even in the case of manganese also we saw xenon. They can show oxidation state of 0 or even plus 1. Like in the case of copper or nickel, it can show 0. Nickel carbonyl, nickel ki oxidation state 0. Any carbonyl for that matter, metal carbonyl, the metal will show 0 oxidation state. And in the case of CuCl, it is showing plus 1 oxidation state. Now, when you consider non-transition elements, especially p-block, down the group, lower oxidation states are more stable. We have seen that in 11th class. Down the group, lower oxidation state is more stable due to inert pair effect. And variability in oxidation state is by 2 units. Supposing if the group number is 4, then down the group you will find they will show plus 2 valency. Plus 2 oxidation state. Okay. and non-transition elements, they generally do not show zero oxidation state. See, these are the main differences between transition and non-transition elements. Then